If a power outage occurred right now, would you lose a precious document you're working on? There's a great chance that your document would be lost and you would be stuck trying to remember what you just typed. Making sure that you save your work is very important. If you're working along with me on the cover letter, that means you've already downloaded the document. But have you saved it? To save a document, click the Microsoft Office button and a menu will appear. You have two main choices here, Save and Save As. We also have the choice to save using the Quick Access toolbar. I want to take a moment to explain the difference between Save and Save As. Save will save the current file under the same name in the same location. For example, the name of this file is Cover Letter. When I decided to save my file, the name of the file remained Cover Letter. The name of this file will not change until I do Save As and choose to change the name of the file. Save As will always bring up the Save As window, allowing you to change the file name and its save location. For example, at the moment, my cover letter is saved in the My Documents folder. By selecting Save As, I have other options. I'm going to choose my desktop as the new location to save my file. Now that we are working in Word 2007, our files are not compatible to previous versions of Word. But the good news is, we can make them compatible so that our friends and coworkers with previous versions won't have problems accessing our files. To save in a compatible mode, go back to the Office button, select Save As, and select Word 97 through 2003. By selecting this option, users with previous versions will be able to read your files, but they may not be able to edit some features. We'll get to that later. Sometimes you may need to save a document and you're not quite sure what software the other person has. You can save it as a file that is readable by all computers called a PDF. PDF is short for Portable Document Format. To save a document as a PDF, we first have to download an extension. To download the extension that will allow you to start publishing documents in a PDF format, click on the Office button, select Save As, then select Find Add-ins for Other File Formats. This will lead you to the Microsoft Office webpage, and from here, you'll follow the instructions and download the extension. Once the extension is downloaded, go back to your Office button and pay attention to the newly added Save As PDF option. To save your file as a PDF, select PDF or XPS. Then decide where you're going to save your file. I'm going to leave mine in my Documents folder. I'm going to name it Cover Letter ABC, just so I know that it's different than any previous file that I've saved. And you want to make sure that where it says Save As Type, you want to make sure that PDF is selected. If all of this is correct, then you'll click on Publish. Depending on your computer, it might take a little while for it to publish the file. Once the PDF is published, it'll look something like this. As you can see, Word 2007 does not keep you from being able to share documents with those who have previous versions. It simply gives you additional options.